Good day, students. I am Dr. Monica Khetarpal. I am Associate Professor of Physics in Government Dungar College, Bikaner. Today, I will deal a lecture on superconductivity. This is a topic of MSc Final Physics, first paper, fifth paper. What are superconductors? Superconductors are the materials which possess infinite conductivity. That means zero resistivity below a certain temperature called transition temperature or critical temperature. Above this temperature, the material will behave as a normal material. In my previous lectures, I have dealt with the thermal properties, Meissner effect, types of superconductors. Now, today I am going to discuss another important aspect of superconductivity. This theory is BCS theory of superconductivity. This theory is named after the scientist Bardeen, Cooper and Schrieffer. Initially, this theory was predicted by Frohlich and Bardeen. They considered the electron-phonon-electron interaction. They found that when an electron moves through the lattice, this moving electron will distort the lattice. And this lattice will turn on another electron by the motion of electrostatic force between them. That means there is an interaction between two electrons by a lattice. This distortion is quantized in terms of phonons, and we can say that in a lattice, there is a constant emission and reabsorption of phonon. The scientists showed that this phonon is not an actual phonon. It is an virtual phonon. Initial discovery was by Frohlich and Bardeen, and later Bardeen, Cooper and Schrieffer extended this theory for superconductors. And they showed that, for this purpose, I'm showing this by a diagram. Here, this is an electron, first electron, which has a wave vector k. This electron enters the lattice. This is lattice. It interacts with one of the lattice site. And by the interaction of this electron to a lattice site, a virtual phonon, which I am denoting by a wavy line, this virtual phonon is emitted. This virtual phonon has a wave vector q. Now, this incoming electron is scattered with a wave vector k minus q, according to the conservation law of momentum. Here I am taking h cross to be equal to 1. Now, this phonon interacts with the another lattice site, which is shown here. This virtual phonon is absorbed here. Here there is an interaction with another electron which has a wave vector k dash. Now this second electron scatters with a wave vector k dash plus q according to the conservation law of momentum. That means here there is an interaction between these two electrons, and this interaction occurs through a phonon which is a virtual phonon. So, an impossible interaction. Why I am saying impossible interaction? Because these two electrons, they have the same charge. Hence, according to the theory, Coulomb interaction theory, there must be a repulsion force between these two electrons. So they cannot interact. But Bardeen, Cooper, and Schaefer, they showed that this interaction, that means our interaction between these two electrons, takes place through a virtual phonon, and this interaction is possible only when this interaction, which is attractive, this is greater than the electron-electron repulsive force. That means the basic condition for the occurrence of superconductivity is that attractive interaction between two electrons by a means of a phonon must be greater than the usual Coulomb repulsive interaction. So students, this is the basic condition that a superconductor must follow. Now I am going to discuss Cooper pair. What are Cooper pair? As we have seen that two electrons interact, and they interact through a phonon. These two electrons, which are interacting through a virtual phonon, these two electrons, they form a bound state, and they are said to form a pair, which is termed as Cooper pair. Do all the electrons form a Cooper pair? Is it possible? No, this is not possible. There are some specific conditions that must be followed so that there is a formation of Cooper pair. What are that conditions that must be followed? As we have seen that when there are electrons in a system, then there are two types of interaction. This interaction can be both repulsive and attractive. Both interactions can happen, but for our condition, what is the basic condition? We have shown it that this repulsive interaction must be less than the attractive energy between electron, phonon, electron. This condition must be followed by electrons to form a Cooper pair. Another important condition is that these two electrons, which are forming a Cooper pair, they must have almost the same energy. The next condition that must be followed by these two electrons is that these two electrons must have a linear momentum, which must be equal and opposite. That is, if one electron has a momentum K, another electron must have momentum minus K. Here, I am taking momentum H cross K, H cross 2 be equal to 1. And if we write the linear momentum as MV, then I am showing the first electron, which is moving in a direction right side. Another electron must have an opposite momentum. I am showing it by opposite arrow, that is towards the left hand side. These two electrons must have opposite spin. That is, if one electron has a spin half, other electron must have spin minus half. That is, if one electron has a spin up, other must have spin down. Now, these conditions must be followed by electrons to form a Cooper pair. And these two electrons, which form a Cooper pair, they are termed as mate. Collectively, they form a pair known as Cooper pair, and these individual electrons, they are termed as mate, M-A-T-E. Now, what are these two Cooper pair? Since these Cooper pair, electrons of this Cooper pair, they will be surrounded by phonons, they are termed as quasi-particles. Quasi-particles are the particles which are surrounded by some field. And these are the electrons which are surrounded by a field, and that field is field of phonons. Hence, they are termed as quasi-particles. These two electrons can form a Cooper pair if the distance between them is 10 raised to power minus 8 meter to 10 raised to power minus 6 meters. As we have already shown that their momentum must be equal and opposite, and similar condition is followed for spin, which must be also equal and opposite. Hence, conservation of linear momentum and spin must be followed in this electron-phonon electron interaction. So we can say, out of the all electrons, only a few electrons will participate in the formation of Cooper pair. The electrons which will follow the condition summation k equal to zero, summation s equal to zero, they can only participate in the formation of Cooper pair. Now, these electrons which follow the condition as stated above must lie in an energy range EF minus half kb theta d to EF plus half kb theta d. This I am showing by diagram. This is the Fermi level, Fermi energy EF. Surrounding the Fermi energy, I am showing the energy level above and the energy level below the Fermi level. The electrons in the intermediate range, they can only form a Cooper pair. Here, theta d is the Debye temperature, kb is the Boltzmann constant. Now, what is the width of this spherical shell from which electrons are forming the Cooper pair? The width of this energy shell can be obtained as, because one energy level is above the Fermi level, so I am writing it as EF plus delta, and one is below the Fermi level, so I am substituting it as EF minus delta. And to determine the width, I am subtracting them, so I got 2 delta. And it is clear from this figure that this width is equal to kb theta d. And energy is h cross omega, and it is surrounding the Fermi level, so omega is written as Debye frequency. So h cross omega d is equal to kb theta d. This is the width of energy shell from which electrons participate to form the Cooper pair. It can be, this energy range can also be depicted by energy level form shown in the form of a spherical shell. This is the Fermi energy, and this is the energy range above the Fermi level depicted as EF plus delta, and this is the energy level below the Fermi level EF minus delta, and the width being, I have determined it to be 2 delta, which we have found out to be equal to kb theta d. So superconductivity occurs only when we have two electrons interacting through each other via a phonon, and this interaction must be attractive. That means it supersedes the repulsive Coulomb interaction, then only superconductivity is possible. And the electrons which are forming pair, they are mate, and they collectively form a pair which is termed as a Cooper pair. I hope you must have understood what I taught you today. Thank you, students, for watching.